Hi folks, this is the 12th video of the Script Manager how-to. With the last video I just showed you that there was a problem with the edit element of the list of the links titler. So first let's have a look again at the functionality that we want to have. If I create a new script, say some batch processing, some info about the process. If I create a new script titler, the links tab just contains one information, which is create a links container. So I create the container which creates a titler that says batch processing dot links. This is just a name. It is tagged batch processing and it is tagged links. The content of the titler is a JSON file, so it's the type is set to application JSON. Yeah, and if we add a new element, there is an automatic index which is assigned, and here we can have some external links to text.txt and some more info about the file. If I say, yeah, as you can see, there is two actions that we had already with the 10th video. This is the cancel and the OK button, and I say OK. And as you can see, it creates a new index here, which is the timestamp. Yeah, this is a very easy index, and goes down to the second. So you could create every second, you could create a new new element. So this should be OK. Yeah. OK. Then the next one. Here I wanted to have the same text again, so I just store it because it should be easy if you have several elements to edit it in an easy way and get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So if you have similar links, copy pasting should be easy. Yeah, and if there is something wrong, we want to have the possibility to edit, to cancel, and to delete the element. Yeah. Okay, how is this done now? As I showed you, there was a problem. Now we have a temporary titler that also contains different elements, and it contains elements for every array. So if I click open, yeah, you can see I do have an element for every line. Yeah, and if I say okay, then it sets this information, and this is just a temporary titler. And it also contains this info. Yeah. So it makes debugging a little bit easier. So that's why I included the index link here. Yeah, to save the state of the edit element. The cool thing now is that we don't have any dirty tagging, because temp titlers don't trigger dirty handling. Yeah. So if I save everything and then I change some text here, there is no dirty handling anymore. And also here, cancel. So this is much better behavior in my opinion. Okay, what else can we do here? We have this titler and we have the possibility to clone it. Just clone it and I remove the first two elements. Okay. So now we have two different links. This is wanted behavior, and it's possible to edit every single one of them in a different way. Yeah, that's what I wanted to have. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's the functionality, and with the next video we will have a closer look at how everything is put together. Have fun, see you in the next video.